So let's take a look at food inflation. It is a topical subject because people are worried that this year, 2014, we will see an El Nino which may affect the monsoon and consequently food inflation in India. So let's look at what is actually driving food inflation and what has been driving food inflation over the last several years. The first observation that we see is that in India, a lot of food is subject to what is known as administered prices or minimum support prices. The MSP is set by the government to ensure that the farmers get a minimum remunerative income over and above their costs. Over a period of time, these MSPs have been increased and have been increased at a very sharp pace. And this in turn has contributed to inflation itself. Let me explain how. Increase in MSP leads to increase in food prices. Increase in food prices leads to an increase in the consumer price index because it has a very large weight to food. In turn, a rise in inflation leads to a rise in rural wages or the wages of agricultural laborers. The MSP is set taking into account this increase in rural wages, and thus it feeds back into the increase in MSP in the next year. So therefore, there has been a vicious cycle of continuously increasing prices and wages in rural India in the last several years. If you take a look at the data over a period of time, one thing is apparent, especially in 2009-2010. 2009 was a very bad monsoon year, with rainfall being just 77% of its long period average. That is, it was deficient to the extent of 23%. This is a drought. Nevertheless, in 2010, the food inflation was lower than in 2009. How did this happen? Let's look at the cycle of food production. Rains this year leads to harvest at the end of the year. The rains come on. The monsoon is between July to September. That's when the sowing season is. Harvest starts in December and onwards, and therefore it affects food prices in the following year. Thanks to the bad monsoon of 2009, you should have expected a much higher food inflation in 2010. However, 2009 saw a much lower increase in MSPs as compared to the previous year, 2008, and consequently 2010 actually saw food inflation come down relative to the previous year. This year, for example, in 2014, we are subject to the MSP increases of 2013. On average, MSPs in 2013 were increased by just 6.5% compared to over 18% the previous year. The last year, we saw food inflation hovering between 12 and 14% mark thanks to the very large MSP increases the previous year. This year, already food inflation has come down to 8% thanks to the much lower 6.5% increase in MSP. What is immediately apparent is it is not the monsoon which is the biggest driver of food inflation in India, but actually the increase in MSP. We will be looking very closely both at the progress of the monsoon, but more importantly at how MSPs change in this year to take a call on what happens in inflation going forward. But in the near term, it does appear that we are headed for much softer food inflation.
Mutual fund investments are subject to market risks. Read all scheme-related documents carefully.